Do you know who I am?
Thriller.
City.
You might need a theme song for your shit. Check this out. Turn it up loud. Let the shit seep in. JackThriller.com. We creep in. Snoop Dogg to the left. Jack Thriller to the right. JackThriller.com. Do it all night. Hit the website. Hit us up real quick. If you're trying to get hooked up with a bad super bitch.
Gold Thriller, Jack Thriller, on these niggas. Gold Thriller,
and Cuddy. All right, and we back, new Jack Thriller City, man. Hey, I gotta go ahead and introduce my co-host today, man. Hey, Cousin Committee is in the building. You know, the guy they call formerly known as Lil Playboy. Give it up for Playboy.
Yo, what up?
All right. Okay, right on the Cousin Committee. Come on, this is my other cousin. Give it up for YBT.
Yo.
Come on now. And then, the queen of comedy. The queen of comedy. Y'all give it up for Erica Dutchess.
Yes, man.
And show me the money. Gigi McGuire is in the building.
It's me.
Hey. One of my childhood crushes is here today, man. You know what I'm saying? I asked my cousin to go ahead and get her on the show and everything. You know, I couldn't believe he made it happen for me. I can't believe we was on the phone together talking about shit. I used to listen to all her songs. I love her name. I love her voice. You know what I'm saying? The body is banging from head to toe. Woo! She's like Dr. Pepper. And y'all know how much I love Dr. Pepper. Playboy.
Yo.
Yo, who we got in the building
Man,
today?
We got Miss 22, Miss Onion Booty. From the Chi-Town to the A-Town, CEO of the Ratchet Rehearsal, Zaytown Global A&R, my best friend, my homegirl, one of my day one partners, man. Hey, Coco Kiss in the motherfucking building.
Coco Kiss. God damn.
Thank you. That was an introductory.
Oh, come on, man. It's fit for a queen. Fit for a queen. Hey, right off the top, you got one of the coolest names in the world.
Thank you.
You know, I know you didn't answer this question before, mm-hmm. but you ain't did it on my platform. I mean, how you get Coco Kiss?
Okay, so that goes way.
I like Coco and kissing.
Thank you. That goes way back into my childhood. Like before I was born, my sisters always talked about how I used to be in my mom's stomach kicking. And then when I came out, my mom called me Coco because I was like her Coco baby because my other sisters are, you know, we all different complexions. So I was her Coco.
Y'all got different daddies?
No. They got the same daddy. I got my own daddy.
Oh, you had your own daddy.
Yeah, I got my own daddy.
I don't want that nigga. Give me this nigga right here. Mama, stop fucking
him. I got my own daddy. But I'm the baby. Yeah, so I got my own daddy.
Saving the best for last.
They saved the best for last. Mm. So my mom called me Coco. So when I was like little, they used to call me Coco Kixie as a joke. So, you know, fast forward, you know, when I started promoting and getting in the club scene and stuff like that, I was going by Coco, but they was like, you need to have something else, you know, that could pipe your name up, you know, when I had the song Onion Booty. So we came up with Kiss.
That booty crazy.
Yeah. So
like
Coco Kiss.
Again.
Thank you. So it went from Coco
again.
Kiss.
Man, so crazy.
It went from Coco Kixie to Coco Kiss. So that's where I got the name from.
That hard.
Yeah, thank
that
you.
That hard.
Yeah, I was kicking as a baby. I was ready to come out.
Are you ready to come out? Are you here?
I'm here.
Are you staying out?
And I made
You're not going back in there?
I ain't going back.
That's what's up. Mm-hmm. So, Chicago.
The west suburbs of Chicago. Let's make it clear. I'm a
the good neighborhood.
Yeah, the good neighborhood.
Got you. Uh-huh, uh-huh. Over there by Chance the Rapper them.
No, not Chance the Rapper.
Over there by Obama them?
No, we just.
Over there by Farrakhan them?
Second biggest city.
Got you.
Second biggest city outside of Chicago. It's called Aurora, but I'm from the west suburbs of Chicago.
I can dig it. Mm-hmm. I can dig it. So, where the rapping start?
It was when I came to Atlanta and I was in the studio one time and I was just like, I want to rap. And, you know, it went from them making the beat to me hopping on the track. My very first record I ever recorded went viral. So that's how it happened for me. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
You like the Michelle rap?
I don't think so.
Yeah, Erica definitely just said
Hold on, Gigi, baby.
Erica just said that.
I Erica and Gigi. Y'all think I sound like Michelle for real?
Yes.
Gigi don't come for me.
You
sis.
Sound like you.
Thank
but
you.
She is the only other person we know who has this type of voice.
I understand.
I like her a lot.
I understand.
So that's what the correlation.
Yeah, I understand. Erica, I'm coming for you, Erica. Yeah. Just by the way, my real name is Erica.
Hey. Yeah. Get out of here.
It is. And it means powerful. So every time somebody say Erica,
it means powerful, enemy, warrior. Mm-hmm.
Exactly. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yes, that's a beautiful name.
Yes.
Yeah.
I want to see y'all fight.
Fight?
No. What?
It was right there.
He want to see y'all mud wrestle.
It was right there.
Oh, mud wrestle, yeah.
Yes.
That's what Jack
He want to see y'all wrestle with some baby oil.
Okay.
Grab her booty. Grab her booty, Erica. Grab her booty, Erica.
We are about the same height. It will be a fair fight. We
got it will be.
About to be of what? A girl fight.
That's funny.
I didn't know that, but that's good. Coco, you've been here for a minute. Yeah. You've been around a long time.
Thank you.
So you got some new stuff coming back out. What made you want to get back into it? Like, you see what the game missing?
Well, it was like I never left, but I had turned my head to, like, the executive side of the business because I was like, they make more money on that side. Yeah. You know what I mean? So I love that I can actually be an artist or be an executive whenever I feel like it.
Oh, okay.
So, I mean, that's exciting, you know what I'm saying? So I can go to DJ some more and be like, play my record, or I could be like, hey, I got 25 artists. I need you to play their records. Here's the bag. You feel me?
Okay, boss ladies. Well, that's Erica, what we doing. That's Erica stuff.
Yeah, that powerful stuff. That
Erica, stuff. Ask her zodiac sign. I already know it.
What's your zodiac sign?
Aquarius.
Aquarius.
Come on, sister.
Aquarius.
You're
an Aquarius? Yes.
Come on. Wait, January.
Wow. I'm January.
January what?
20th. I started off. You I kick it out. Well, yes, I'm the president. You know, I'm inauguration day. Yeah. January 20th. Yeah. Well, I'm calling myself the president.
I'm STEM. I'm in there. February 4th.
Okay.
I'm full, baby.
I got two best friends whose birthday is February 4th. So we good.
Yeah, that's crazy. It's just, I don't know what it is. Maybe
it's a connection.
It's something.
My sister's birthday, February 4th.
How you feel about her, Gigi? Yeah.
She my little baby.
What's your sign?
Gemini.
Hey, earlier, hey Coco, you missed it. Earlier, it was a Gemini committee. I was in here sweating.
But look, again, all day on this chair, we all air signs.
Yeah. Gemini.
And we get you.
I have a lot of Aquarius, especially women in my family and in my close circle of girlfriends.
Mm-hmm.
And yeah, like this.
Absolutely. We the only ones that will really, we'll let a Gemini tweak, but y'all don't really go too hard with us. Y'all will go crazier with everybody else but us. Mm-hmm. I think y'all know we know y'all.
I think that's everybody with Aquarius, though.
Mm-hmm. And my big sister is a Gemini, so I understand. And she calls me her baby, but I'd be like, sometimes I'm not your baby, but, you know. Because she is Gemini.
Yeah.
That's sweet.
Yeah. Like
Coco, so you got this showcase that you do called Ratchet Rehearsal. Mm-hmm. You break a lot of big artists in the city, and you bring a lot of big artists that's already established to the city.
Mm-hmm.
Can you tell us a little bit more about it, though?
Yeah, I can tell you the first thing is that I had a little Playboy on my show, y'all.
Hey.
He performed.
It was lit.
Let me start off with that. Nah, he came through. You came through with the moon boots, and you had a lot of money. You had a stripper. It was just like a show, you know. And that's what's
don't forget my Superman.
You had your
Superman. I
brought
Superman. My Superman out just for you. I barely bring him out.
But what's important about the showcase, and let's give it up for my business partner. Hey, Jetty. Y'all see Jetty over there in the orange.
What's up, Jetty?
Hey, Jetty.
Hey,
Jetty.
Female empowerment.
Yeah, well, fine stuff.
Yeah, she fine, too. Look.
Yes, she is. She deserves work.
Ratchet Rehearsals, we've been in business for 3 years. We've helped over 700 artists in less than amount of 3 years because we give 25 artists a platform each time we do the show. So I do 25 artists, and I've been doing it once a month since 2021. So I basically, you know, give artists the opportunity to get artist development and things like that. And then I give them a platform and then go from there. I give them tours, concert opportunities and things like that.
So how did the name Ratchet Rehearsal come apart?
Do you really want to know?
Yes.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
So like I was telling y'all before, as an artist, I was understanding in the city, it's a lot of people saying that they can do things for artists and they really don't deliver.
Can't.
Right.
Exactly. They be capped. So I called myself the bridge in the gap, and I wanted to be the one to say, hey, if y'all really, you know, really want these things done, I can do these things for you. So I start consulting for artists because I got connections. All of my connections that I use for myself, I start sharing them with the artists, and I gave them, you know, actually the platform. But within that, I had to, hold on, wait, where was I at? I lost my whole train of thought
you
looking at
sharing
Jack.
Your connection.
Yeah,
oh, and your plugs with the artist.
Girl, you better stop.
Oh, I look Jack, because you, I looked at you.
You better go somewhere.
It was because you were smirking at me, so I got thrown off. But I basically pretty much gave the artist the opportunity to perform on the platform because I felt like everybody else was shading the artist and not doing what they were saying they were going to do. So I was doing consulting, and with my consultant, I would have the artist perform for me because I specialize in stage etiquette. I don't do anything else. Mm. I just teach you how to work stage left and right, center stage, make sure your record is mixed and mastered, and so on. So with that being said, I start doing that. I had an artist that was on my consultation, and she was an asshole. And I got mad. I'm like, you know what? I'm going to just start calling this shit ratchet rehearsals whenever I do consultations. And it came out of anger. But when I said it, I was like, I'm actually going to do the show. And I did the show a week later after I got mad. I had put all the artists that I had been working with on one show.
Yeah.
And then it started from there.
Hey, you know what time it is. It's Jack Thriller's Beauty of the Week, hosted by Gigi McGuire. Show me the honeys.
It's your girl, Gigi McGuire. And we are here with this week's Jack's Beauty of the Week. And your name is?
Lola Cash.
Lola Cash. Woo! Hey, girl.
Hey, how are you?
How old are you, baby?
I am 34.
34. And what sign?
I am a lucky Libra.
Lucky Libra. My daughter's a Libra.
That's the scale, right?
Yes.
Okay, half and half. All right. She unbalanced.
I'm very balanced.
Oh, okay.
Balanced on that Libra scale.
Okay, like on a complete breakfast.
And where are you from, hometown?
I'm from Atlanta, south side of Atlanta.
Come on, south side, shorty. Mm-hmm.
What? Okay.
My alter ego is from the south side as well, because she's been here for 18 years. Okay?
Yes.
Time to get a little spicy. You ready, girl?
Let's do it.
So let's start with your sexual interests. Like, we doing men only? Are we straight? Are we gay? Are we bi? Are we curious?
I am straight as a line.
Straight, straight, and straight some more. Okay. And what might your favorite sexual activity be? We're going to take it a little broader than just positions because that's so basic. So sexual activity.
Sexual activity.
Favorite sexual activity.
Sex is my favorite activity.
All of them. A-L-L-U-H-M-N. All of them. Okay. I'm here for that.
She got a rose too.
And, huh?
She got a rose.
Tattoo, right?
Couple. No, that one when you did the thing that what y'all be doing with the thing.
Oh, don't we all?
Oh, that's how they going around? They on sale?
Shit.
Okay.
And what would be your thoughts on 50-50 relationships?
I ain't doing no 50-50.
Hello.
Hello. I like 100%.
Okay.
Okay, she paying for everything.
That's no, I ain't up. Paying for nothing.
Oh, that's not. Oh, okay. That's not what you meant. Okay.
She said Lola is keeping that cash in the bank. Hello.
Okay. Okay,
she's spending his.
Her money is your money. His money is your money, huh?
His money,
no,
her
his
money.
His money is my money, and my money is
and
my
her
money.
Her money is her money as
God
well.
God damn.
How often do you fake an orgasm?
Never.
Never, ever in life.
Never, ever, ever, ever.
Orgasm.
No.
Oh, so that means you gonna, you like, if I can't make you come, you gonna do it yourself, and we still gonna be cool and be fucking.
I'm gonna get the fuck up.
Oh. Right in the middle?
In the middle.
Oh, damn. Damn.
I ain't got time to play with nobody.
Oh, you're not gonna leave, are you?
Oh yes.
Damn. It's over?
Over. OB.
Okay. I might win some, but I just lost.
I don't
one.
Got time to play with nobody, son.
I just lost one.
Okay.
All right, Miss Lola. Can you please let the people know where to find you?
Yes, you can follow me on Instagram at @1LolaCash with a K, TikTok at @Lola.cash with a K.
Lola.cash with a K on the tickety tock, she said.
Thank you, honey. It was nice talking to you.
Thank you.
Hey, J-O-N.
That's dope. That's yeah. I never story. Knew that. I never knew that story. Mm-hmm. I thought it was just like some catchy ass shit, but I didn't know.
Nah, somebody made me mad.
I don't think I never seen you mad.
Exactly.
How
no
you sound
one.
When you get mad?
I don't sound.
Because she don't get mad.
Nah, I don't. I am queen of the silent treatment. Like, I'm one of them types that I could be silent with my nigga in the house for a whole 2 weeks and mean that goodness. And stand on it until he say he apologized.
Wow, man, with that booty, hey, I'm sorry. Now,
yeah, you know they do. Yeah, they do. Man. That's when you get cute around the house. Ain't that right, Gigi and Erica?
Yes.
Yeah, when they start cutting up, you get cute around the house and you be stiff. So they apologize.
Very stiff.
Mm.
Very like an animal.
Mm. Keep going.
Yeah, but that's how I started ratchet rehearsals, out of frustration. But it came from, you know, the artist actually being ratchet.
Right.
Yeah, but the name kind of took off. You know what I'm saying? Like, everything.
It's definitely catchy.
everything yeah. that I feel like I'm associated with, from Dirty Girls to Onion Booty to Ratchet Rehearsals, is like, dang, you always saying something ghetto, but yeah. it works for me.
Yeah.
Yeah.
What tell us some of the artists you done work with on the Ratchet Rehearsal platform.
As far as like new artists or
just period. Just give us a list of some of the big folks you done had there and some of the new people that
shout
you, know,
out
you put
out.
On there that's taking off too, that you know
we
that
need to
help break in the city. That ain't as big as, you know, some of the people you have had, like LA and Sari, you know, but you know, some other people as well.
Well, to attest to what you're saying, I've had, like you said, LA, Young LA, Sari the Kid, Waka Flocka, Zaytoven, okay. Crime Mob, Jugman, am I missing anybody, Jetty? Jazzy Faye. Yes, that's crappy. So I have a lot of, you know, people supporting me from the city because they see me. Mm-hmm. And half them niggas used to be my neighbors, too. So,
right.
like, you know what I mean? I'll be seeing them in the hallway, like, you're coming to my show, you know? But at the end of the day, I feel like it's a lot that I'm doing for the artists. So when it comes to putting people on, I break new artists. So I don't really name drop because I like people that don't even have nothing already.
Right.
So organic.
Exactly. Like mm-hmm. I like an artist awesome. That don't even have distribution, that don't have publishing, that don't have anything. And then I take them to the next level. I teach them how to get publishing, distribution, you know, how to create LLCs. We teach financial literacy as well as artist development.
Nah, that's
dope. Nice. And that's something that's well needed.
That's a bit dope.
That's something that's well needed. It's so much gatekeeping going on in the industry. That, you know, what you're doing is rare and it's filling a void, for mm-hmm. one. For two,
thank you.
The support of Atlanta, and I'm going to come to Erica with this one because she love Atlanta, and I love Atlanta too. And I'm not from here, you know, I'm a transplant, but I've mm-hmm. been here 18 years and I'm never leaving. Like,
right.
if I move out of Atlanta, I'm moving to the Bahamas or the goddamn right. Cozumel somewhere or something. Like, right. other than that, I'm right here. But in the hip hop community and the industry and just speaking of Atlanta, we definitely are always there for our people and we hold our people down and we don't gatekeep. And I think that is something that we, should be applauded for because in cities like New York and Philly and Baltimore, they don't do that. They gatekeep. They don't want to help you. They don't want to share their resources. Mm-hmm. She's sharing all her resources and not only is she helping people, she's making a bag from it. Exactly. But there's so many people in other cities that don't have that mindset. And don't see the vision of I can help and I'm going to get my blessing given back or I can help and make a bag off of it. So I applaud you for that. And
thank
I want to
you.
Applaud the city for holding it down and just, you know, really being yes. supportive because I see in other cities that they do not do that at all.
Thank you so much. Yes.
Yes.
Thank you.
It's big. Okay. We have our little issues here and there, though.
But we still family and we stick together no matter what. Oops. And we ain't gonna let nobody else come in here and do nothing to nobody.
No.
I don't give a fuck if I just fought you yesterday, nah. bitch. If a bitch from goddamn Tuscaloosa come over here and she got a problem with you, I'm sticking with you. Like
okay.
I could have
okay.
just fought you yesterday,
okay.
but now I'm on your team. Cause fuck her
that's
and her
fuck
people.
Fuck her.
That's how I'm gonna
fuck her.
Fuck her.
Right.
Yes.
Fuck her, girl.
Hush.
I yes. always say that.
Hush.
Atlanta had a culture shock for me because me, I'm not from here either. And what did you call us, Gigi? We
transplant.
Yeah. I like that. I'm a transplant in Atlanta. I don't know. I just like
what
that.
But you be claiming Decatur, though.
I never claimed Decatur.
You went to school in Decatur.
I did go to school in
you
Decatur.
You said something on your side. You like Canada Road.
On my record?
Yeah.
Because that's where I be hanging out. Like,
yeah,
I get my hair and nails done in the hood.
Yeah.
Like, I'm not going to Buckhead for no fresh set. No bundles, none of that. I'm going
me
to
neither.
Decatur.
I get my nails done on Old National.
Yeah, you got to go to the hood for the original stuff.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah, but I do rep East Atlanta if you wanted to know. Yes,
I heard it.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, she heard it.
Yeah, because I got some dip off.
How long you been on the
East
side
up in here?
Huh? How long you been on the East side?
I came to the East side when I moved to Atlanta. So I came
year?
Here when I was in 11th grade in Atlanta.
Yeah.
So I
what high
go to school
you went
here.
To?
I went to MLK.
Okay.
Yeah, on the east side.
Yep.
Yeah. So I'm still, I went to high school here. I guess that's credibility.
It counts.
Yeah, it counts.
It counts.
It was a culture shock. I always tell my friends I came here. It was like my principal was black. My fireman was black.
My principal is black.
I mean, you know.
My Lambo, too.
Everybody. Your doctor is black. Your nurse is black.
Yeah,
I love Atlanta.
That's one thing that I love about Atlanta. Atlanta is like
black
filled
black
around
black.
Black people, man.
Mm-hmm.
And it's more
black
millionaires. The black man get more respect in Atlanta.
Mm-hmm.
I preach this all the time. Like,
that's
I've been to New Orleans and got mistreated at Louis Vuitton.
No.
I done been to Burberry and Temple and then got mistreated.
Yeah.
And I go to Atlanta. Them folks happy to take our money.
Yes.
They ain't double checking your ID. They ain't shaming you down like you're a thief or some shit. Because Marking Atlanta, we all know that black people get money. We eat out here. We watch each other back and we protect each other. Mm-hmm. But it's like, I feel like there's no other city like Atlanta when it comes to black, as a black man. I don't know how black women feel, but as a black man, there's no better city for a black man to live in. I don't think I'll never move outside of Atlanta. Because I don't like the stereotype or the racism or, or people trying to look at you and just, oh, that's just another nigga. You don't know who I am. I might have a doctor's degree. I might have $10 million in my bank.
Let me tell you, when I first moved here from Philly in 2005, I just went to Philly to get my hair done last week. I fly home to Philly every month to get my hair done. Like, so I would go home to Philly and they would ask me, how you like Atlanta? Oh, you just moved to Atlanta. How you like it? And I swear to God, 18 years later, my answer is still the same. The people are nice. The city is clean. And all of the black people, it's just black excellence. You see black owned businesses and you see educated black people. And I tell the story of when I was in a gas station. One of my first days here, I was in a gas station. And a nigga pulled up in the Benz. He got like a white tee and a fitted. And he trying to holler at me. So we talking. And then I'm looking at him like, oh, he must sell drugs. Or, you know, he must rap or something, right? This man pulls out his business card. It was like, I own an accounting firm. I was looking at him like, what the fuck? Okay. Yeah. And, you know, when I danced at Medic City, there was women who owned check cashing places and daycare centers and beauty salons.
All kind
and
of shit.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah. And owning their homes at that, you know, so long ago. You know, and it's just like where I'm from, you don't see that. Mm-hmm. Even myself, when I left Magic City, I became an entrepreneur. I opened up a pole fitness studio. And if I was still living in Philly at that time, that wouldn't have never been something I would have tried to achieve. I would have never thought in my wildest dreams that an uneducated stripper could be an entrepreneur.
No, you
but being here in Atlanta opened my eyes. Smart booty. being in Atlanta opened my eyes to the opportunity that it can be achieved, you know?
Yeah.
So, yeah. And again, it ain't no other city like it. You're right.
It's not. It's not. Coco, being that you're a female.
She is a female.
Yes. And this is a male dominant industry. Did you take on any like hardship because you're a female? Did anybody just try you because you was a female? Or do you feel like you get it the hardest because you is a female?
I do. I feel like it's always, I tell everybody all the time, when it comes to my business, I don't have no issue with female artists. I have issues with the male artists.
Mm-mm.
They the divos. You know what I'm saying? They balls big. They feel like they know better. Half of them just, I don't even want to say nothing shady, but it's just like, you know, women really just got something that men don't have. And it's
a male ego.
It's
pussy.
That's right. But it's
and you know what? That pussy has 6 brains, okay? Because if you were to ask me a question right now, I would give you like 6 different perceptions because I'm a woman. I got different ways POVs. Of thinking about it. You know what I'm saying? But a man is one track. You know, he's going to give you one straight logical answer, which is nothing wrong with that. But women, we got 6 brains. You know, we got our heart. We got our vagina. We got the day, we got our mood, you know what I mean? It's those emotions.
And we can talk from all different spaces.
Yeah.
And understand.
So when a man talks to a woman, understand she got 6 different ways she can reply. But she gonna choose the best one if you're the one that's, you know, giving her the comfortability to have the best answer.
Comfortability is
Yes, sister. You hear me, Jack?
Yeah, I heard you.
Okay.
Hey, man, we back. Jack, talk to him.
Yo, Foodie Call, man, you got this. Let's go, Money Bag Mafia.
Boy, Money Bag, man. We got my boy 7 Flavors in this motherfucker.
Yes.
Go on, give it to
see
him.
See what's going on today. We're not going to play with y'all. We got our lamb. We got the tropical lamb chops. And we got the coconut island rice. You know, this is not no regular food. You got to taste it for yourself to see what it's about. It's not no regular lamb chops. Everything is marinated. It actually has some jerk sauce in it, a little bit of honey.
The jerk on the lamb?
Come on now.
Put a jerk on.
I told you. Silence. I told you. Come on.
Look,
now.
When you buy that Lambo, come when on. You buy your Lambo, you gotta get it jerked.
You gotta. You gotta
put a jerk on the lamb, my boy.
This is real Caribbean island. You know what I'm saying?
Ti, need. Hey, Ti, you need to holler at these trap down there, yeah, in Trap City now.
Nigga, for real.
Y'all ain't got no jerk lamb.
Get this nigga at Bankhead Seafood too.
It's not called Seven Flavors for no reason.
Okay, man. What we got here? What kind of rice?
So today we got the coconut island rice. Not only the fact that
island rice.
Yes.
Okay, you from Ghana though, right?
From Ghana. Yeah.
Do y'all do the fufu too?
Fufu, we do jollof rice, we do everything you could think of.
You gotta bring some fufu up here. I tried it once, I don't think it was right, man.
If you have some fufu, you're gonna fall asleep in here though.
I'll fall asleep. I was constipated for like 2 weeks.
But you're
gonna fall asleep.
I was drawing blood. Oh my god. Coconut what rice?
Coconut island rice.
Coconut island rice. I'll buy that just off the name.
Okay.
I ain't bullshitting.
Let's go.
Hey, man, there you have it, man. We got marinated lamb. What's the flavors on the lamb? We got jerk lamb.
You got jerk lamb. You got a hint of honey in there.
Oh, my God.
You know, you got the seasonings. This is marinated overnight. Like I said, none of the food that I make is a 1 hour process. It's a 5 to overnight process. You know, it's me with love, me and the whole team. We take our time, make sure y'all enjoy the flavors. And that's why it's called Seven Flavors.
Man, enough is enough, bro.
You, man, let them know where to find you. Done said enough of it.
I'm hungry,
man. Let them know where to find you, at, man.
You're on Instagram, Facebook, Snapchat, TikTok, Seven Flavors. Okay. Yeah, we ain't on y'all.
He for real.
There you have it, man.
Foodie call.
Foo-foo call.
I see.
Yes, sister.
Okay,
I like you.
I like you,
too. My spirit telling me to just pitch this thing to you, too. We're going to talk about that after.
That.
Spirit.
Okay.
So,
down.
Coco, being that you work with both, like, male and female artists, do you find that one over the other is easier to work with in terms of, like, being coachable and just being able to receive information and not taking it extremely personally?
If I were to choose... I wouldn't choose. It's just based on the artist and their character and their financial status, because I know that you have to have money, and I kind of get frustrated with some artists when I tell them, like, hey, you got to invest in yourself. I did. Mm-hmm. You know, I'm not trying to make you spend this money because I want a couple of dollars. You got to pay because the people that I'm going to for what you need done got their hands stuck out. Mm-hmm. And you got to invest in yourself. Nobody else going to spend a bag on you if you don't even get yourself off the ground at least. You know, even with me being a female, like, before I came to this show, I had to make sure I was on point. You know, a nigga, he can just go get a haircut, throw on a white tee and some fresh forces and call it a day.
Not this nigga.
You knew you was coming to see me, though.
I was coming to see Jack.
Not this nigga.
But the average, you not an average nigga, but the average one, average. Definitely.
Yeah. So an average nigga with a nice haircut and a white t-shirt and some white t-shirt and some white Air Force Ones.
He can pull me. He can pull me.
If he came and holler at you, you wouldn't...
I'll go, because he clean, you know. It's not about the labels and things like that, you know.
So the bar is he clean.
If he says the right thing, though.
Yeah.
You just
not
heard.
Just off the look.
We just heard a guy.
He's presentable because he's cleaned up, but he definitely has to, you know, say the right thing.
I don't even feel comfortable talking to a girl if I got a white t-shirt on. That's the shit I wear around my house.
Kind of like
but
that.
Yeah, because you had them on like
yourself.
Back in the day.
This ain't that day no more.
Yeah. No, she's funny for that. That's a good one. Right. Yeah, right. His perception period. Different because his t-shirt was longer. So it's
Yeah. We ain't talking about the extra long tee. Yeah. We talking about the regular. We talking about the waist length. We talking about the regular length tee. Not the extra long tee.
Did you see how a nigga get a couple dollars of change on you?
That's so funny.
Boy, I would remember your
wife. I wouldn't be caught dead.
Long
extra
long
tees. You
had to go to Foot Locker to
get
the official
one. But to answer your question, the gas station wasn't
official. The men,
but they still had them.
They had them.
The men are actually more like they usually have their investment. The females are harder to deal with once they're locked in. The men are harder to deal with when you're trying to deal with them. Like once you gain the artist male trust, it's cool. Once you gain the female trust, it's like not cool. It's like it's crazy. You know, it's you know.
It's the opposite.
Yeah, because you know, once you know, Erica and Gigi, once we love you, it's like now the cycle turns on.
Yeah,
you know what I mean?
Yeah, that's so true. Like soon, like when they be chasing you, they give you, they just be loving you and giving you, telling you everything you want to hear.
As soon as they
but
got
then
you.
Once they know they you love them, they be wanting to just pipe up on you. I'm like, bruh.
Male and female.
Like damn,
that's
interesting.
Yeah, there are men do. I mean, a lot, like at least 85. 92.5% of the men be doing that. Like, it's just from my experience. It seemed like I just from other people's stories. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? It be all Cinderella in the beginning, but as soon as he got you, it's like, dang.
Erica, that's why you gotta do like months. You gotta be like, okay, 3 months I'm gonna be nice, and 3 months I'm not gonna be nice.
Oh, put me down. Mm-hmm.
You got it down.
Put me down.
I hate that game, Gigi. I feel you, because I know you like, I'm too grown for that. But no, you gotta kind of do it.
Put me down, because, girl, I just.
Kind of gotta do it.
I ended a relationship because I felt like once he had me, I compared it to bank accounts. It's like when I was in the checking account and he had to, like, you know, make sure everything was good at all times, I was handled a little bit with more care. Mm. But once he knew I was all in and I'm now in the savings account and he ain't got to worry about me no more, then he kind of eased up on, no, nigga, keep on with the keeping on. Like, don't stop now because you know I'm yours. Like, man, you supposed to go harder now that you got me to prove that, you know, I need to stay here.
That,
like,
happened in my marriage.
What does that mean when they
say go harder now that you got me?
Keep up with your consistency.
Keep that same energy.
Exactly.
Woman, so you want this nigga to keep trying to impress you and go on.
Not impressed.
But keep up. Okay, so if of course, like when a man trying to impress a woman, I'm gonna take you somewhere nice. We maybe, you know, like I said, one of these little trips somewhere, that $2,500 trip, $800 restaurant, shit like that. Yeah, that's to impress you and wing you in, but if you expect for a man to do that every week,
That's not what I'm talking about. I'm talking about staying consistent with just communication.
And loving on me.
Staying consistent with the reassurance, with the compliments. It's a small, it's a little, being thoughtful. Exactly.
You guys are describing courtship. You want your man to court you.
Still.
No, what they're describing is pay attention to detail. Like, if I say I like flowers, buy me flowers.
Exactly.
If I say clean the toilet, clean the toilet. If I say I want you to take a shower before you lay down so I can feel sexy and not feel like you're dirty, take a shower before you go to bed.
Coco, you saying if
hold on, do that last part again? Huh? The last part you said.
I didn't hear you either.
I said take it, like, you know, women don't like a man getting in their bed dirty.
Oh, okay. Take a shower for it.
Yeah, but what y'all understand? Look, I gotta fix my nail, y'all. My nail kit.
It's all good.
No, it's all
I'm
good.
A girl's girl. Okay, I got my nail kit. My purse.
It's okay.
One thing that you were saying, Coco, is if I say, but there's some women who expect to not have to say anything.
Yeah,
they are. They don't know how to communicate.
They don't know how to ask what they want.
But that's a lot of women, though. Like, a lot of women be like, you're just supposed to know. That's
probably, no, you're not. I don't agree with that.
About 75% of the women, you supposed to know.
Do you think that's just them needing to grow up? Do you think that's them needing to...
They don't understand the value of communication.
They need to grow up.
Yeah.
You will know who you're dating once they don't know how to tell you what they want.
Exactly.
Even down to what they want
to eat.
Yeah, women, like a grown woman, she gonna know what she wants.
We gonna know. I'm gonna know he don't like this and them grit, that bitch, don't put no this, no salt in his grits, don't do this.
Put, we gonna
know, we gonna know everything about that man, cause we
pay attention to what,
you know what I'm saying? But they do switch up. Like when I got married, I never ever told a man how much money I make or nothing, showed him anything.
That's not cool.
Cause that's,
it ain't none of your business.
Something ain't none of your business. But when I got married,
hold, cut, time out.
How much money you make ain't their business?
Excuse me?
I'm talking about before I got married.
Oh, before you got married. I thought...
Before I got married. Gotcha.
When you married, you ain't gonna tell your husband how much you make?
She will then, right?
She told him when he was married.
Usually, when I was dating guys, I never told him how much money. Right. But when I got married, I was thinking that was the right thing to do. Now, mind you, he was gonna call my dad. I'm gonna take care of her. I'm gonna do this. I'm gonna do that. All that, right? So when
he told him how much money he made.
So when I said, come on, let's look at our finances. You know what I'm saying? Let's see what we finna build and where we finna grow. Like, show me yours, and then I'm going to show you mine. Mm-hmm. When he showed me his, like, my heart, like...
Dropped.
Why?
Because I'm like, this all you got, like, all in your whole life.
Is it?
Like, this your whole, like, in your entire life. This is, but you be going and doing concrete. You got all these contracts. This is not the number.
Nigga that spent that shit on you.
No, he didn't. No, he
didn't. Where the rest
of it? And then when I showed mine, I was like, oh, this is going to be an issue. But when I showed him mine, it made him back down on just wanting to be that person for me. You know what I'm saying? That want to take care of me, want to provide and stuff like
that. Why do you think that is? Do you think that your figure made him feel less than or insecure about what he brings?
Probably
to
both. Yes. Probably both.
I want my girl to make more money than me.
I hate that.
And it's so sad. It's like, and that's just one genre. It's just a lot of things that go with that once a man know that they got you or you a certain type of woman, a dominant woman, they say alpha, whatever that is. But I really want to be soft, nigga, like that. Yeah.
Me too. That's really what we want.
I think y'all only want to be soft for certain moments. Like, you know what I'm saying?
Say it again. Say that louder.
Girl, I'm tired.
I feel like you want it because I get a kick out of feeling empowered all day. But, you know, you do want to feel nurtured when you do get with your man.
Of course we want balance.
Love you, Coco. Yeah.
We want balance. We want to have our bossy, our bossed up times, but we also want to have our baby times.
Fuck,
I want you to know that I got that in.
But I get it. I get
baby,
the balance.
Daddy, am I your baby? Like,
Daddy, I'm your baby.
Daddy, am I your baby?
I say that to somebody. I can't say it now, but like,
can I hear you say it, Erica? Can you say it in your best tone?
Say it again.
Erica from the West Side.
But she still delivered. Them West Side chicks know how to talk cute with they niggas.
Yeah, we know how to talk. Each other be gang. They be like, "Shaw, you all cap." And I said, I'm like, "Daddy, I'm your baby." He's like, "Man, so cap ass up."
Such a cap ass up.
It sounded good to me, Erica.
Yeah, "Daddy, am I your baby?"
Okay, Gigi. You know Gigi gonna do it better than all of us, baby. Yeah.
But women, we have it. It's so, man.
But we like y'all, though. I want men to know, like, we don't hate men. We enjoy everything about y'all, you know. Okay. It's just y'all. It's just, I think, actually, I was just telling Jetty the other day, my homegirl Jetty, my business partner. I was telling her the other day, I'm like, hanging around certain males, I realize a lot of them be going through divorces and breakups, and it really be on their mind more than we thought. Because we think they don't talk about it, but they be hurt. Y'all be hurt when y'all with y'all boys.
The difference between women and men is it's kind of like the switch, like you were saying with your artist. Mm-hmm. So in the beginning, a woman is like all distraught and sad and, "Oh my God, we broke up. It's over," you know? Yep, yep. And the man is like, "Fuck that bitch, where the next one at?" Yep. And then the woman gets into her, "Fuck that nigga, I'm about my life shit." Yeah. And now he like, "Damn, I miss my bitch."
Yeah.
Like, it kind of flip flops. Yeah. You know, they go through it. We go through it first, and then they go through it last.
Yeah. Yeah.
But we all go through it.
Yeah.
You know?
We do.
It's rough.
Yeah. And that narcissist thing is heavy out here.
Yeah.
I just had to do my own research on it. And it's different levels of
narcissism.
Yeah. Are y'all aware of narcissism as
men? Narcissism is a real disease. I didn't know
women
that.
Women are narcissistic.
It's like a mental illness.
It really is.
It's a real disease.
It's a real human thing.
My first time ever hearing about it, I used to hear people talk about Trump, say, "Oh, he's a narcissism and all this." But I thought it was just like calling somebody ugly or stinky, like an adjective. Yeah. Mm-hmm. But it's an actual disease you can get diagnosed with at the doctor. I did not know that.
Like bipolar?
Bipolar. It's a mental illness.
It's themed from like childhood.
It's trauma.
Especially
driven.
When a man don't have like a dominant woman in his life, it triggers something in the male cortisone or something. I don't know. But I know what I did with me studying and being with men that, you know what I'm saying, suffer from that or whatnot. It made me go back to my son, my oldest son, who was with me through like everything, the trenches and slept with me in the cars and all that. And I see he got some of the symptoms. So I had to go back as a mama and just apologize for certain things or awaken him on why I had to be the way I was, raising you by myself and not knowing the DNA of a man. You know what I'm saying? I'm just coming from this standpoint as a mother and as a woman, but it do trigger them. So that helped him like with his therapy and stuff like that. I didn't even know that he was talking to his therapist about certain things. You know what I'm saying?
Wow.
Just how you talk, tone, like I can get real, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. Hey, nigga, put that shit down, nigga. What the fuck wrong with you, boy? I'm gonna do the lame ass shit, nigga. You know, they do something to a child, you know what I'm saying? But you just thinking, you a mom, you raising men. And
you gotta be strong.
Yeah. So you talk to them a little different. But once I got older and started realizing, even like in my relationship, the men be like, "Damn, Shadow, when you said such and such, they just did something to him." I be like, "You know what? I know I got a powerful mouth, because therefore I wouldn't even be no comedian." You know what I'm saying? This mouth of mine is a gift in so many ways. So I had to talk to myself. I can take accountability for it. But like, you know what, Shaw, you need to really learn how to start talking to people a little bit, you know what I'm saying, without being so aggressive. You know what I'm saying? Because even with my little girl, she going to be kind of rough because I talk to her crazy. You know what I'm saying? I don't call out her name like, bitch, and I hear folk call their daughter. But I don't talk like that, but I would get in that ass. You know what I'm saying? And shit like that. So I just think that would come from like.
You only do what you know, Erica. Someone gave you that knowledge and you just passed it down to your kids. That's what happened with all of us. I tell everybody all the time, all of us know who we are from second grade. Like, you can remember yourself from second grade, right? You can't remember who you were in second grade?
I can.
I remember my teacher, but I don't remember who I was as a young kid.
I remember.
I think I was quiet. In second grade, I was quiet, and I didn't get ratchet and bats and turn. I didn't get my identity until probably like in fourth grade.
Not even that, but you can remember back to something that happened in second grade.
Yeah,
right?
I can remember that.
So you knew you at that time. You knew how you responded. You knew your character. You knew who your teacher was. Yeah. I ain't no telling what Jack was doing in second grade.
No telling.
Ain't no telling.
Seven years old. Oh yeah, that was a good birthday. But yeah, I was on one. Uh-huh. I was very into myself. I felt very sexy. Yeah, I was out there.
Okay.
At seven?
At seven, yeah.
Jack, I was very bad. Dad at 10. I can imagine what he was doing at seven.
Yeah. You said he did what at 10?
I was very advanced.
I'll let him say it.
I think I heard what you said. I just wanted to make sure that's what
you
I heard.
It. Okay. If you think you heard it, you did.
Yeah, okay.
What you was doing at 10 years old, Jack?
Oh, getting molested right. The right way.
There is no right way to get
wow. I like what Erica said about DNA because I feel so strong about that. Like, I want children. I don't have any kids.
You don't?
I don't. But I'm like, because of that.
I don't got no kids either. Yeah. This is crazy.
Jack, you trying to have a baby?
I mean, we could talk about it.
Okay, I got to hear you out. I got to know if anything going on with you because I'm real, like, inquisitive. I'm going to ask questions. Like, you got this going on.
I have answers.
You know what I mean?
This is crazy.
Because if your blood type is not right, right. You can actually
mine is
create
O positive.
A sick baby.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. What's your blood type?
I'm going to say it online because I don't want nobody looking for me trying to procreate.
Oh, they going to be running that game on you.
Yeah, you feel me? About telling my blood type, they going to hit me.
That means she got that good blood.
I'm AB.
Yeah. If you know, you know. With the good blood.
No, I was just talking shit.
And I just really learned about that, like when I got pregnant, about different blood types and stuff like that. I didn't know anything. I thought my doctor was trying to tell me I had something, but in a doctor kind of way. Because he was like, you is
so funny.
Like, if I said, doc, if you say positive with any, you still say, I'm thinking this nigga though. I'm thinking he don't gave me something.
Heart rate though.
Yeah, I was like, you trying to break it down. You know what I'm saying? To me, but I'm a teenager, so you not trying to just give it to me straight. I like, boy. But yeah.
You should use that in one of your comedies. Like,
yeah. You know, I keep saying that every time I be like, but I got a new set. I'm finna start working on my new set, so.
You gotta come see. You gotta come see.
I'm the queen. I do this. Ain't nobody fucking with me. Nobody.
Talk that shit.
I don't line them up.
Knock them down.
I don't see them. Cause everybody like this is my gift. Like this is what God want me to do. Cause I just knew I was gonna be either a stripper or a real estate agent. Either one.
One of the two.
It was going to be
listen,
either
a lot
one.
Of strippers end up being real estate agents.
And then there's that.
That's where I was going. But thank God for the lady at my job that I had. And she told me you were missing out on your calling. And I went and tried it out. But I noticed what I was supposed to be doing. I was just looking back on some stuff. I remember I used to go to barbershops and ask them, can I tell them some jokes? Wow. Just because people used to tell me, only reason why they laughing because they know you. You know what I'm saying?
Right. Bitch ass.
Go around some people you don't know. So I go around some people I don't know. To the barbershops, to the salon. Like, hey, can I do some joke? They be like, yeah, do some joke. Clapping, everybody clapping. Girl, you funny, girl. Yeah. You funny, girl. You know the old lady going to tell you. You know what I'm saying? So I noticed what God. But it's deeper than that. It's deeper than comedy. It ain't all about just making people laugh. When he give you a platform and he give you this gift that gravitate people to you, you got to do right by it.
Right.
So it's deeper. In my DM, it's nothing about nobody. Some people say, girl, you did good last night. But I have stories that makes me sad. You know, they be telling me about people that don't molested them, people being on them. I like, hold on, Lord. I thought I was supposed to just be making them laugh. But it's deeper than that. So I have to find out what else I supposed to be doing, because it's not just, this is just a starting point of it. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
But I love, like, women, you know what I'm saying? They come to me and they tell me, I love us. That's why I did, a couple years ago, I did From Teens to Queens. Mm-hmm. I put a whole event together by myself in 30 days. Mm-hmm. I rented out me on a little warehouse, got some tables. Some people just start coming stuff. And donating stuff.
I remember that.
That prayed for me and everything. I had a whole movement.
Mm-hmm.
I got the internet influencers for the little girl, like Jessica the Prankster. And I got, like, some pastors, some ministers for the women. It was just a moment. We was in that thing preaching and networking and crying. Yeah. And it was just that. That's time. What it's all about.
Yeah.
And somebody told me, they said, you get so caught up in your calling, you forget your purpose.
Mm-hmm. Right.
Wow. So that's the hard. Purpose, man.
That's a big thing, because one of my biggest prayers every day is I'll be like, God, allow me to walk in my purpose and don't let my time pass me by.
I love that.
I say that every day.
Yeah.
And it's crazy that you're talking about a calling, because remember when I sat down and y'all were like talking about my voice?
Yes.
It's like I get critiqued about it, but at the same time, people listen to me because I talk like this. But I got something to say if you listen. You know?
Sure. You've been saying a lot.
Yeah. You do know we take you seriously, right?
I do know that. I know that. Because I take me seriously. So I know nobody taking me for a joke.
100%.
Yeah. And I'm very aggressive. I'm going to approach you.
You are.
Yeah. Even when I came in here, I spoke to Gigi. I'm like, you know, Gigi is... Gigi, you know what I'm saying?
I saw what you did. You're like, what's up, bitch? I heard what you said.
Yeah. I would not say that. But, you know, for me, it's like, you know, you got staples in the city. And it's certain people, when you see them, you're like, you show respect because they changed the culture. And she changed the culture.
Yes, she did.
You know what I'm saying? So when I see her, I don't really be liking to approach nobody. But I'm like, hey, Gigi, because... it's respect. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. And I was talking to her. I'm like, I bet these bitches don't know to say what's up to you. Mm-hmm. But at the end of the day, you changed the culture and you're an impact of Atlanta. We appreciate you.
Oh, yes. I appreciate you.
Look at that.
Thank you. Thank you.
I love it.
Excellent.
Yeah, she got stuck. Folk be at me. Can you please just tell Gigi to call me nigga? No.
Gigi was a Barbie.
That's a Gigi effect.
I love it. I love it.
I got next to her. I'm damn sure I ain't finna be telling you know this.
I love it.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah. You're a legend, though. You know that.
Yeah, she
is. I love.
And you cooler than a mug. I'm just giving you a flower.
I taught her how to do that. I taught her how to be like that.
You,
Jackie taught me.
It's just you, your whole aura is just so womanly. Mm-hmm. If that a word, I just made it up. But it's a woman.
I like it.
I'm trying to mix woman and welcoming together. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Womanly. Yes.
Womanly. I appreciate that.
Yeah.
I really do appreciate that, because when people look at me and assume I'm a certain way, mm-hmm. they think because I look very polished and, you know, bougie, that I think that I'm better than people, or that
you know, not I look down bougie. On people,
or yes, I do, or that I know I look bougie, or that I'm, you know, that I'm not approachable.
Right.
And it's when they get to know me, I get this a lot, like, dang, I ain't think you was going to be this cool. You know, seeing you on the show, I hear you talking, but I still look at you like, damn, I just really was on a date with somebody and they told me that for a long time they had a crush on me and that they, you know, was scared to approach me because they thought that I was unapproachable. And I'm just like, I'm very much approachable.
So
like,
somebody going on a date with Gigi?
Yeah.
Who Gigi date?
That's what I'm saying.
We might not have a second date, but.
Okay.
I know.
So you dating the fine Mr. Right, or you just dating to go eat some lobster tails? And
I buy my own.
She
want to
get married.
That's a good question.
She want
to
get married.
I buy my own lobster, and I'm not even going to the restaurant to buy lobster tails. I'm gonna find that public and cook them myself.
That's right.
No,
that's right.
Yeah.
Gigi cook.
Actually, I'm gonna go to the farmer's market and get them, because they're Gigi cook cheaper. Yeah, I'll be cooking. Like, really,
I'll be cooking.
No, I really can cook.
That's what I be doing.
But yeah, so. For Erica to say that, I really appreciate that, because I know the type of woman I am. I know that I am caregiving and welcoming, and I am known to have taken my shirt off my back and give it to somebody.
Like, do it, yeah. Do it now.
I've done that. I was a manager at a strip club, and this girl couldn't find her shirt, and I literally took my shirt off and said, "Bitch, go home." put the shirt on and go home. Yeah. And I'm just that person. I'm gonna help those around me. I'm gonna take initiative to fix something. I'm gonna take initiative to give my advice if I know that it might help. And people don't see me that way because, you know, they get, I don't know, this perception that they have because of how I might look. But yeah. I'm definitely not that person. First of all, I'm a whole nigga. Like, I look like this, but I act like a man. I act like a boy. Like, I'm very rough and I'm soft and pink on the outside, but I'm very rough and very masculine in my thought process.
Me too.
Is more of a man's thought process. I don't know if that's why I eat pussy or not, but my thought process is more of a man's thought process compared to how women think. And I'll be talking to my brothers or my homeboys, and they'd be like, do I have to remind you that you're not a man? Like, you are a woman. Like, act like a woman. And right. I'd be like, I can't help how I think and how I feel. Like, I might agree with the men more than I agree with the women, but I still know that I'm a woman. But that don't mean that I'm acting like a man. This is just who I am.
Right.
But I honestly think it's because I was supposed to be a boy. Like, for real. Like, my mother's whole, you know, I was born in 79, so it wasn't no ultrasound, gender reveal. You know, you ain't see what the baby was until you seen the pussy or penis. So, my mom had three girls. I'm the baby. And her whole pregnancy, they're like, oh, she finally getting her boy. I had a boy name and everything. And then I came out a girl. But at the same time, I have brothers that are my age, and I was raised around. My sisters were older than me. My brothers were my same age.
What was going to be your boy name?
With the boys.
What was gonna be your boy name?
I don't know. I gotta ask my sister. I never cared to know.
Like a George.
George. So, yo, my real name is Kafi. It's Kafi.
Hold on, what?
Kafi.
I like that.
That's Kafi. Hard. Yeah. Your mom is kosher?
No, it's Hindu. My mom was an herbalist. My mom was like Erykah Badu in the 70s.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Yeah, she was barefoot all the time. She was always in like muumuus and like That's she incredible. Wore her real hair and like individual braids with like the shells and beads and stuff. Yeah. And she
was doing that at the time where it was like
in the 70s.
Wow. So it's trendy now, but that's the time.
That's the time.
So this is the lifestyle I was raised in.
Flower like children.
We were exactly. I knew about moon water when I was a little kid. Incredible. I thought that everybody knew about moon water.
No.
Yeah, I knew about moon water when I was a kid.
Gigi, what's moon water?
On the first day of a full moon, you take some purified or distilled water and you put it in preferably a glass container and you sit it up under the moon and it absorbs the power of that moon. And you can drink it, you can bathe in it, you can spray your plants with it. It was a thing, like, make moon water when it's a new moon. I thought everybody did that. Like, even growing up with, like, nutritional stuff, everything was fresh vegetables, nothing frozen, nothing out of a can. We didn't drink soda. I didn't have fast food. I didn't have McDonald's until I was 12. We weren't allowed to eat candy or anything like processed, like American cheese whiz out the can. Like, I didn't have none of that stuff. Everything was all natural. Our snacks and our candy was like trail mix and chocolate covered raisins and dried fruit. Like, I grew up eating like that.
Do you still implement any of those things that you learned from your mother now in your adulthood? You do.
I act just like my mother. I am my mother.
Mm. Wow.
Mm. And you said she's like herbal.
I cook. I clean. I'm a plant lady. Mm. I'm incense and thumb. Plants, and I got an altar. And I'm moon stones. And
I like your mama.
And crystals. And
are you a healer?
I've been told that I have
no, she didn't kill
the
niggas.
Gift.
She done killed niggas. Yeah.
I'm a killer. We gotta tell you the story.
She fucked the ex-boyfriend. He had a heart attack and died mid-sex.
For real, Gigi?
He didn't die during the sex, but he died.
Wow.
Yeah. We just talked about it in the last episode, so it's fresh.
So she's not a healer. She's a killer.
But no, I didn't think that. I have been told that I have that. You know,
healing.
That
thigh out.
A healing spirit, yeah. That nutrient.
But I get that from my mother. Like, my mother was, my mother's house, and like, my ultimate goal in life is to open up a restaurant in honor of my mother and serve the dishes that I grew up eating. My mother always put her own little spin on something to make it special, and she always said that the number one ingredient is love. And that's how I cook. I cook in my house, and I use fresh everything. We making biscuits from scratch. Like, we not buying a box of cornbread. I'm in cornbread from scratch, like, and this is because this is how I was raised.
That's right.
Yeah. You know, everything fresh, not frozen, the vegetables, everything fresh. And I just want to help and take care of people. Like, mm-hmm. I just want to bring you in and just make you better if I can. So I guess that would be considered
that's what
a healer
is. Yeah, you are a healer. It's, yeah. You define.
So I like that. Yeah. And people don't know that I'm like that until they see it. And then they're like, oh, damn, I never thought that you was, you know, I thought that you was this way. And it's just like, I'm the complete opposite of it.
Where's your mother from originally?
Philly.
Philly. Mm-hmm. Do you know where she got any of those traditions or practices from?
Her mother wasn't as deep into it. But her mother was sort of the same way. My great grandmother was the same way. So it was like a long lineage of the women in my family. But I think my mom took it to the next level because of the era that she was in.
Right.
It was mm-hmm. the 60s and the That's 70s. Right. And, you know, I grew up with weed being a regular thing.
That's right. Because you know? It is.
I was going to ask that too.
Smoking, I started smoking weed with my grandmother when I was 15.
Wow.
I would come home from school with a blunt for Gigi. Gigi is my grandmother.
Yeah.
So I would. That's where I got my name from. So I would come from home from school with a blunt for Gigi, and we would sit before I went and did my homework. Me and Gigi would sit in the basement, and she lived in my mom's basement. We would sit in the basement and smoke. And the reason why is because I was outside with my friends sneaking and smoking. And I would come in the house high, and Gigi was like, "You think we don't know you smoking?
Come on,
like, yeah." She said, "You gonna get in trouble if you get caught outside. Come in here and smoke with me, and then they when they smell it, they're going to think it's me. Ain't nobody going to think you smoking." Wow. And from the age of 15, every single day when I went home from school, I smoked the blunt with my grandmother.
My grandma ain't never do that with me.
Coolest
and then I started smoking with my mom. Yeah, I started smoking. I want to show you this picture. It's my favorite picture of my mom. I posted it the day that she passed away. And then I recreated the picture.
When her birthday?
October 28th.
Oh, she a Scorpio.
She was a Scorpio. Yeah. She passed away in let me turn my brightness up. She passed away in August of 2017. Aww. And so it had been 6 years last year. My father passed away on my mother's birthday.
Hey, hug her. Y'all hug her.
You want to hug her?
Y'all hug her.
Zach said, can we hug you, Gigi?
Yes,
we can hug you.
Yes, thank you. Yeah, it's a whole nother story behind.
Thank you for sharing that story, that intimate story.
Oh my God.
That's a beautiful story.
I want to show you all that, and then I'm going to show you all I recreated it. And I recreated it around the time of her birthday, I think it was, when I was in Tulum. And then I'm going to try to get my daughter to do it. My daughter is, like, very tomboy-y, so I don't know if she going to do it, but this is my recreation of it.
Wow. That's beautiful.
Oh, wow, that is.
Yeah, I recreated it. So I have a cannabis line that I'm working on, and that's the picture that I'm going to use for my logo. They actually just sent me some mock-up renderings of the...
Is that your mom?
That's me.
That's you.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm, she redid her
I redid my mom's picture.
Yeah,
yeah.
Wow. Yeah, she redid her
mom's
picture.
So I redid my mom's picture.
Gigi.
And then I'm a... so this is the picture that I'm using for my cannabis line, for the logo. But I'm going to try to get my daughter to recreate it, too. I got to talk her into it.
Yeah,
if I could talk her into it, I think that would be dope. For
I thought that was your mom. You look like twins.
I
like
her.
Yeah.
What are you going to call the cannabis line?
Coffee.
Your name.
I'm trying to think if I want to be like Cannabis by Coffee or Clouds. Like, I'm trying to like play with names, but I'm definitely using my name. And
how
when
do you
I
spell
do the rest,
that?
K-A-F-I. This is what I wear on my chain. K-A-F-I. And when I do the restaurant, it's going to be my mother's name, which is Bienta.
Yeah.
Yeah. Very unique, right?
Yeah.
Are y'all
I love that. That's awesome.
I like that. Huh? It's like all of it just coming together. You get
full circle, huh?
Yeah.
Yep. Wow. Yeah. That's God, ain't? Mm-hmm. Divine timing and purpose.
Yeah.
Coco, how old you was when you started smoking?
Huh? She's like, huh?
Oh my bad. Coco don't smoke, y'all. Coco don't smoke.
Just say no.
I don't smoke. Erica, how old you was when you started smoking?
Well, I don't smoke no more, but I started smoking. I was like 14.
14.
I started smoking. I'll never forget. Me and my best friend had on got us some weed, went behind the building.
You know it's bad when you insinuate
that. We went behind the building, and we were singing that song by Tupac. Why the hell to kill my nigga?
Kato.
Hey,
we named the blunt K.O.
Oh, so y'all was the first ones naming y'all blunts after
yeah,
that folks.
We did.
That ain't nothing new.
We did.
That's
it first.
Fucking hilarious.
Lord, rest in peace to my friend, my bestie Nikki. Boy, she gone. We talk about that. We was talking about that, you know, all the time. K.O. That's was the name of our little joint.
Well, I know my brother don't smoke. I know my cousin don't smoke. And I just wanted to ask about this for females. Would you marry a woman that smoke?
When you say smoke, do you mean the act of smoking?
Yes.
Or do you mean like edibles or like
the act of smoking.
Butter. Smoking weed,
anything. Weed, cigarette, right. Vapes, shit like that.
So, weed, yes. But here's the stipulation. You can't be one of those people where I can't eat unless I'm high. I can't sleep unless I'm high.
I hate that.
I got to get high before I go.
Yeah.
If you're one of those type of people, it's going to put a damper on everything that we do, and I will never enjoy time with
you. So let me, and not being like defensive because I am one of those type people, but it's not that I can't eat unless I'm high. It's when you start smoking weed and you really like become a real smoker, it controls your appetite. So I'm not going to want to eat. I'm going to smell the food and I'm going to want to eat the food, but I'm only take two bites if I ain't smoke first. So that's what it is. It's not because I gotta be high. It's weed really. You heard Cat Williams, hungry, happy, sleepy. That's what weed do to you.
When you say control your appetite,
anybody in the room can understand what I'm saying?
She's saying it's not mental. Yeah. She's saying it's not mental. It's literally you can't
it's
do
a
it.
Physical,
you
it's can't. A physical thing.
You're not
when
hungry.
And I remember I took this girl on a date one time, and she was like, she couldn't
smoker,
eat.
You not because
she ain't
smoke.
I never seen that girl again.
And you
feel it's not that you want to be high. It's that you know you're not going to eat. No matter how hungry you might feel, you're going to make a plate, and you're going to take two bites of it. But if you roll up a blunt and smoke, you're going to fuck that plate up.
Luke I. Walker.
Now, I don't have to be high to do everything else.
You smoking? I mean, you marrying a woman that smoke.
And guess
this. Luke I. Walker. You married a woman that smoked cigarette, vapes, weed, blunt.
You know what? I was married for like 6 months. And
you know what?
I was just telling my friends the other day, I don't like guys that do too much of any of that. Just for the purposes.
Come on now.
Like, I definitely engage in all the above.
Okay.
But I'm occasional and coke? I'm social, not coke.
Okay.
Let me not say all the above, but here and there, I dibble and dabble. Well, I like drinking.
Dibble and dabble.
And I do like herbs. Mm-hmm. But I'm not going to be like trying to find somebody that match my energy. I actually like a guy that don't do either. Like all the guys I dated in the past, they didn't drink or smoke.
Or snout that powder. Oh, my God.
And they really are way more attractive than the guys that drink
my
and smoke.
My favorite. My favorite boyfriend right now. That nigga smoke hella weed. And I be so happy, like, yes, babe, bro.
I realize that girls that smoke like that like guys that smoke like that.
Of course.
I remember I was dating a long time ago, I was dating this girl that smoked heavy. And it just like our chemistry really wasn't hitting like that because I ain't smoked, she ain't smoked. And then she ended up marrying a dude, having babies and happy family. And it's a nigga that I knew that was like a big trap nigga. And he smoked every day. And I was like, I knew y'all was going to get together because it just made sense.
Smoke weed every day.
That's all he do. That's all you do. Yeah. Y'all can just.
So, but he's not my favorite because he smoked. But it's just a coincidence.
Why he your favorite?
Why he your favorite?
Because y'all vibing. Y'all high and vibing.
He my favorite because his score rates the highest all around the board.
Oh, okay.
Okay.
What is the board?
Yeah.
You know, when you put everything into accountability. The personality,
the finances,
the looks, the sex, the personality, just him as a person, his integrity level, his mannerisms, his respect for me and himself, his children. You know what I'm saying? Like
and his children.
When you put all of you put that all down versus, you know, this guy and that guy, like he wins.
Go, Gigi.
That's what makes him like my favorite. He knows
I'm
my
being
favorite
single
too.
This year. I don't want nobody.
You heard me. He knows he's my favorite because he know he ain't my
Erica
only.
And Gigi, have y'all ever
oh, my God.
I'm single. He's single, too. It. When you single, you're dating. Yeah. Like, you know.
I don't want nobody. I'm around.
What'd you say?
Have y'all ever dated industry guys?
I haven't. I've had sex with one, but not
oh, my God.
You've been in the industry this long, 15 years, you only slept with one industry guy?
Mm-hmm. I've been in the industry going on 11 years in July. Mm. 11.
11.
And I don't, I don't want them.
So
I'm around, saying, do y'all prefer them?
I don't prefer them. My ex is the president of a major record label. Mm-hmm. And I honestly feel like guys that might want to approach me don't because they know that we were together for so long. We were together for like 11, 12 years.
Mm. Wow.
So I'm known to be his, even though we wasn't married, like I'm known to be his wife. Wow. So it's like, I feel like, you know, guys kind of put me on the, you know.
Back burner.
Not even a back burner, but the untouchable list. Like, I can't even try to holler at her because of the respect for who he is. And not just because of who he is as a person, but how it's high hard. Above he is on the food chain when it comes to the individual. Industry. Like,
that's good. But no, I see, I be around them. The guys that I'm around, I would never want to deal with them.
not saying nothing wrong with them. They good guys.
I ain't gonna say I ain't had a few of them just because. Yeah.
You had to do it.
I don't.
You had to do it.
I don't want no guy.
It was a few before him. It was a few after his ass.
But y'all prefer him though.
I know. I want somebody that got some motion this time. I know. Yeah. I want somebody that's. Yes, equal to mine.
Honestly, yes,
to what I got. Well, going.
So my preference is honestly, the first thing I want from a man is honesty. Like, that's if you fine. Can't keep it real with me, then because I'm gonna keep it real with you across the board. If you can't keep it real with me, then we have a problem. If you feel like you have to lie to me or tell me what you think I might want to hear because I can't handle the truth, then we have a problem.
Come on
that's
now.
That's what men seem to do a lot. They tell us what we want to hear because either they're scared to tell us the truth or they think that the truth is just too much, so they just gonna soften the blow by telling us whatever.
Oh, the truth gonna always fuck that pussy up.
Coco, what about you? You dating the industry?
Let it shut your ass up.
You date in the industry?
You mean recent or have I dated in the past?
Both.
You heard him.
little bit of.
I had an 11-year relationship. Damn. And then after that.
You better go, girl.
Yeah, I've been single for 5 years.
Oh, wow.
Ooh, that's a long time.
That's a long
time. It's nice.
But yeah, when it comes to guys, and I'm going to go back to this guy that I was on a date with that said that he thought that I was unapproachable. I know who I dated in the past, and I know how people look at him, right? But. And even the guy who told me that he didn't want me to smoke no more. I mean, not 65 Day Fiance, but the one who told me he hate weed. Even he is like, you know, somebody up there in the ranks of like wealth and shit like that. But I am not out here looking for a rich nigga. I am out here looking to be a rich bitch. Like, I've learned from dealing with rich men that that's their money. And if they not trying to share or do for you, then you're never going to see it. So they can have it all they want, but it's never going to be yours. So why are you looking
Talk
for that?
That
you
want
to get
shit.
Your own money, right? Now, when it comes to, well, would I date a guy that makes this or makes that? I just need you to meet me where I'm at if you can't take me higher. Meaning, if I'm booking myself Delta Comfort or first class, then don't try to book me on Spirit or Southwest because I'm not going. If I'm putting myself at the Lowe's, the W, the St. Regis, don't try to put me in a Marriott or the Doubletree because I'm not going. And not to say that I'm too good for that, but I've gotten
That's
myself,
what you said.
I've gotten myself to a level of comfortability.
I was trying to use the money for something else.
I've gotten myself to a level of comfortability. So if you can't meet me at my comfort level, then I'm cool.
I feel like that's fair.
Okay.
That's it's fair. Just and that's just like what but, and that goes to my
time,
living arrangements.
But sometimes
right?
everybody that's has that's up and down. To be. So realistically, 1 year. You might not be able to do that for yourself this year. So, and he might not be able to do it either. So, since it's a bad year for everybody,
I'm talking about when I first meet you.
Okay.
When you first, when I first meet you.
Oh.
Now, if
so we
you
can do
drop
spirit
down,
later.
If I drop down, then we're going to hold each other up. Right. I'm
okay.
fine with that.
All right. See, why don't
yeah,
you just
no,
lead,
no, no,
lead
I'm
with
talking
that.
About when I meet a guy. Yeah. If okay. I meet a guy, prime example, I met a guy, I was in Philly. I met a guy, we was in the club talking. I didn't give him my number, because clearly, but we was in the club talking. So, he was like, I was like, oh, I live in Atlanta. He's like, yeah, I be in Atlanta all the time. I said, "Where when you be in Atlanta, where you stay?" And he was like, "What you mean?" I'm like, "He like, what you mean? Like, what area?" I said, "No, what hotel? Like, what hotels you be staying at?" He said, "The Courtyard." I did like this, and he was like, "What? I'm not staying in no Courtyard. Sorry."
You ain't coming to visit him either at the Courtyard.
No, because if we go somewhere, you not gonna expect for me to stay at the Courtyard. I'm not doing it.
Where you gotta stay?
I stay at the W, at the Lowe's, at the St. Regis.
At the W, Wicks, same region.
I'm just saying. Yeah, that's where I'm gonna put myself at.
But realistically,
I just moved myself to Austin for South by
the
Southwest.
The St. Regis
production
and the St. Regis and the W is like three times the price. The W probably. The St. Regis and the W, how much the W?
I'm
about $450. St. Regis like $1,300.
I'm giving the range. You can get the lowest for $200. I'm giving the range.
St. Regis, yeah, like $1,300.
You can do the
I'm
W.
I'm giving a range.
I ain't doing it.
I'm not
you
saying we gotta stay at the St. Regis.
W $250.
But what I'm saying is,
I ain't fucking with the St. Regis.
But what I'm
seasons,
saying is, I'm giving a range of where I'm looking to
okay,
stay.
Yeah.
At least
$100
where I can do for myself.
Right.
Like if you see me with a Chanel bag, don't buy me no Michael Kors bag.
I'm not a Michael Kors bag.
I'm not a Michael Kors bag type of girl. And no shade to the Michael Kors bag because I was a Michael shade. I wasn't always a Rolex girl. I was a Michelle watch girl. Exactly. But now that I got a Rolex, don't buy me no Michelle watch. Respect that.
What about a Movado?
Guess what? I'm not going to do that to you. I'm not buying you no Movado. Okay. I'm not buying you no Samsonite luggage. I'm going to buy you to me.
No G-Shock? You ain't for G-Shock?
I'm going to buy you a Louis Vuitton passport holder, not one from Ross. You get what I'm saying? I expect the same.
Okay.
And this is why I expect it, because I'm going to reciprocate.
All right, put the gun.
I don't want you to give.
Put the gun down, Gigi.
I'm a cake mama.
What's your love language?
Okay.
Physical touch. I want to live in your skin, baby.
Oh,
I want to be with you at all times. I want to touch physical you, touch. On you, kiss on you, huh?
Physical touch,
yeah. Words of affirmation and like gifts and shit, you know. Like,
okay.
And gifts. What's your love language, Coco?
I like what she said, affirmations. I like affirmations.
I need the reassurance. Word of affirmation. We talked about this earlier.
Yeah, that's me. Mm-hmm.
You like words of affirmation?
My reassurance. Yes.
Yeah.
That ain't the love language.
That's words of affirmation.
Yeah. Well, that's ain't what it called.
Yeah, that falls under words of affirmation.
And to pay attention to detail.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Yeah.
And it's the small things. It's not always about the big name ticket.
That makes sense.
Yeah.
I like physical touch and quality time. I don't physical really need words of affirmation. I don't need nobody to tell me I'm handsome every day. I don't need nobody to tell me I smell good.
It's not even just that, though.
Affirmation can be like you can just affirm whatever I have going on in the moment.
Yeah.
If I'm crying, I don't need nobody saying, it's okay to cry.
Go, Tiger, you're the best. I believe in you.
That's not what it is. It's just being present in the moment. Affirming what's like present.
Yeah, being supportive.
Yeah.
Nah, being supportive in words of affirmation is kind of.
No, it's not. It is. Supportive and affirmation is the same. It's the same.
My support is show up. I believe in walking the walk and not talking the talk, because I done seen a lot of homeboys, homegirls, shit, sometimes even family members say they gonna do some shit and they don't do it.
Words.
My thing is like, I don't like words of affirmation. I don't really care about receiving gifts, because like Gigi said, I can buy my own stuff, buy my own shit. What was the other one? I like quality time and physical touch. Like I want to be up underneath you. I don't need the.
But is your hygiene okay to be up underneath me?
I would hope so.
Because that's what the problem is with men. Like, you know, y'all don't think y'all have to be, you know, feet crusty. Guys talk about stretch marks on booty. Mm-hmm. Niggas be having stretch marks on their booty. You know what I'm saying? Niggas feet be crusty. You know what I'm saying? Armpit hair, nappy, you ain't, you know what I'm saying? Like, groom.
I had a baby.
BDB.
Ball hair, nasty.
Ball hair. Don't
nobody like, no. Like, you be a groomer.
So you like a man to manscape?
I do. And I don't say, I'm not saying you got shaved all over your
ball. Don't do it all.
But just clean it up. Make it
the word
nice.
Manscape is crazy. Like, what?
Manscape is a real thing.
I know, but that's so crazy. Just thinking about a manscape.
You like hair? You like hair, Coco?
I like a scape.
Wax or later?
Uh-huh.
I like a scape.
I like a manscape.
Like you want it to be bald?
Yeah, don't be crazy, darling.
Okay. So you don't. What about a landing strip? You cool with a landing strip?
A man with a landing strip?
Yeah.
No.
Okay.
It's either there or not.
I cut it off. I cut it off.
I just don't like it. The hair on their balls. That's the only. I just don't like the hair on the balls.
I pull them.
Cause you be doing the balls, Erica. If you,
who wants some hairy balls in their mouth?
You gotta take care of the balls, girl.
I get it, but
I ain't about to put no hairy balls in nobody's mouth.
Take, like if I'm down there,
say that shit.
If I go down there, it just all hair.
You got the hair.
You know what make me mad?
Yes, I want to know.
What makes me so angry is seeing, like, we like nice draws too. Like, stop wearing bogus draws.
Man, what?
Bogus draws.
I was just telling this to my mama the other day.
I didn't see two guys with their draws inside out. Like, why do I see the name? Like, you know what I'm talking about?
Yeah. No.
When the name of the draws, like, whatever draws y'all wear.
Okay.
No, like the name. Like, 100. Okay. If it say 100% cotton, I can see it written on the ass because you got your draws inside out.
Oh, you're wearing the draws inside out.
Yeah, I see that. What
is that? Yeah.
He washed it inside.
He took them all.
Flipped them inside out and put them back on.
What kind of niggas you be fucking with, my boy?
I didn't say that. I didn't say I fuck with them. I said I see it a lot.
So if you ever dealing with a man and his underwear are inside out, it's because he's trying to get the best use out of
them. That's nasty.
He just got out of jail.
No,
that's what that is.
You can flip him and do it again.
Believe it or not, we looking at that. I've never heard of this. I know Erica and Gigi looking at it.
I go buy some.
I stopped dating the man before because I ain't like the way his boxes look.
Time out. Coco, I got to ask real quick. So this is something going over my head right now. How old are you?
Why you gotta do that?
I need to know why these. What is
this? Just know I'm younger than Gigi and Erica.
Huh?
Just know I'm younger than Gigi.
Oh, I know that. I figured that much.
I'm in my
Playboy friends. I know.
I'm one of Playboy friends. I'm in my early 30s.
Oh, okay. Okay, gotcha. So niggas in their early 30s.
I'm in my early 30s. Yes.
Got you.
Look, young nigga, look, I had to do it a little bit because I be the oldest bitch with all my
I never heard of none of this.
Yeah, I said I'm just starting to know what
I never heard of none of this shit.
I so I can feel like the young bitch and in the room. Friend, didn't I just say that the other day? Jetty,
I love being grown too.
Didn't I tell that? I said.
I'm grown.
I love it.
I know that's right.
Yeah.
I love it.
What is going on right now? Okay.
So I got a friend that lied about her age, and I'd be like, girl, what you lying for?
Okay.
You be lying?
She tell people that she 5 years younger than what she actually is, and she really, like, stand by that. And I just be like.
That shit's stupid.
Yeah. Math ain't mathing, girl. Mm-mm. But, yeah, I never lied about my age. I embrace being older.
Yeah, me too. I'm grown.
Because here's the thing, and then, you know, it's always a lot of, like, old shaming on the internet, right?
It is.
The first thing somebody want to call you is old.
Yeah.
But do you want to die young?
Hey,
ain't that the point?
Motherfucker better hope they get to live to be your age. Motherfucker better hope they get to be your age.
You wanna see 40, you wanna see 50, I wanna see 90.
I love it.
Well, put it this way, Erica.
Young enough to fuck your daddy, old enough to be your mama.
I can fuck your daddy and I can fuck your brother. So I feel good.
Oh my God.
Erica,
you out of control.
Can I hang out with y'all so I can start feeling like the young bitch in the room?
Yeah.
Okay, but because I be hanging out with my girls, they be making me feel like I'm the older bitch in the room.
No, you just mature.
I am. I think that is too. I believe that is.
You're a little wise.
Yeah, take her under your wing.
Take
my girl under your wing.
I'm gonna talk to her about some stuff. She my little sister.
Okay.
Yeah.
Wisdom comes from experience.
That's right. Yeah, and I love it.
Do you want to die young? Do you want to not?
But guess what, though, Jack?
Little experience.
Guess what, though, Jack?
Want to grow old?
Girls like ourselves, we're actually preserved. I feel like we're way
big
more preserved.
Auntie, babe.
Ain't that right, Erica?
Huh?
And Gigi, just because I'm really intrigued in what all of y'all are saying, especially y'all two right now. I feel like women that were born in our era, we a little more preserved than the girls now.
Yeah.
I feel like they doing drugs, they having sex. It's more STDs. It's just more looseness going on.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And I feel like when you hit a certain age bracket, you understand soul ties. You understand being attached. You understand babies.
Come on now.
So you're not just fucking. You know?
Yeah. You're not just fucking. I have all my good. My walls are just so good.
I believe her.
Me too. Me too. Me too.
Big grip is could be my nickname.
They don't even know about gripping.
I'm snatching condoms.
Oh wow.
I snatch every condom.
They have them little contests when you grab stuff and you walk all that back. I'm gonna win.
Baby.
Okay.
I'm gonna win that. Like
that nigga be like, you snatch the condom every time.
I love
go get
everything
it.
About me.
I believe that's the booty hole. I believe y'all bring the booty hole right now.
My booty
hole
is
different. This pussy the condom snatcher.
I ain't never heard that, but that's
you ain't never snatch a condom with your coochie.
You mean
not
like
on
it was,
purpose?
You mean like it was?
She talking about
having sex and the condom slip off because your pussy so tight.
And it was in there, and you had to get it out.
No, it's coming off.
Oh my God!
He gotta pull it back up because it's coming off.
Oh no!
That doesn't mean his dick too little for that condom. Niggas walk around with big ass magnums on and they be in the mini packs.
But no, not that one. He
yeah, them the worst condoms to buy.
Yep, Magnum got a little
Magnum stink,
little STD or something. Or they got a little yeast or something.
Oh my Magnum. God, y'all are hilarious.
Whatever
okay.
They put a little
the
yeast in Magnum
in it is not. It's not good.
I'm on a
pod. All right, let me get this shit back on the course, y'all.
Okay.
All right, so, yo, Coco, you got new music out right now.
Yes, I do.
Yeah, tell us about this project.
Okay. So with my new music being out right now, it's a single. It's called Bone. It's
produced, I love it.
Thank you. It's produced by Zaytoven. I've been working with Zaytoven for a long time. I also do A&R work for his label. So we was, you know, working with some artists, and I'm like, shit, play, you know, make me a beat. You know what I mean? Because I want to get back in the music business as far as what I had going on. Yes, because I toured for 10 years. So I know what is important as far as being on the stage and things like that, because I've made money just off performance. So, you know, I made another record, and I'm putting, you know, together a tour for the artists this year. So I'm like, shit, if I got the stages, why not put a record for me? And then I possibly might hit the stage too, you know?
100%.
Thank you. Yeah. And I tell the artists that all the time. Yeah, nobody else. And I don't mind sharing the stage. I'm not selfish when it comes to the artists and my platform. I've had my show for 3 years, and I've only performed on my own show one time.
Mm. Mm-hmm.
That says a lot.
It does. Yeah.
That's awesome.
Yeah. Yo, every single dope. Month, and you only did it once?
Yeah.
Was it in the beginning?
Yep.
Yeah.
It was in the beginning. Yeah.
Yeah. You have hosts and stuff like that?
I do. I book hosts. I book comedians. You know what I'm saying? Like, yeah. I invest yeah. in people. That's all. Yeah, like, let's chop it up. Yeah. Yeah.
Speaking of comedians, you done did the Country Wayne's and the Desi Banks. Who all you done work with? Let us know.
As far as comedians?
Yeah, skit-wise and your comedian.
Country Wayne, Desi Banks. And then when I do like stuff with Funny Marco, it's more like independent stuff. Like
yeah.
What we did as far as at the studio stuff. But yeah, I've done a lot of skits with.
So you got your hand all over the industry.
Yeah,
all
and I'll be, you know, that what's Proud good about you. These guys that I work with is they open their books to me.
Mm-hmm.
So I've booked Country Wayne. I've booked Zaytoven. Like, so if I'm bringing a lot of business, you know what I mean? They fuck with me because I'm like, I'll bring them a bag. I'll bring them a $60,000 or a $50,000 or a $30,000 deal. And I get my commission. So sometimes I might not have to work for 6 months because I done brought a good deal to Zaytoven or Country Wayne. Or, you know what I mean? And it's not to that magnitude. Look, not to that magnitude. But what I mean is if I'm like real serious about my booking and if I'm like, okay, I'm tuned in and I'm like people hitting me up about different artists, I can eventually or easily run my bag up in a short amount of time. If I focus on that, I can run my bag up. If I focus on my platform, I can run my bag up. If I focus on me. So I just try to create avenues to where I can make money,
multiple streams of income.
Mm-hmm. And most artists don't like sharing their platform, Jack. But one thing about me is I share it and I, you know, create spaces where people can come and do stuff with other people that are involved with me as well.
That's awesome. 100%.
Yeah.
We definitely got to network with you.
Yeah, let me bring y'all some business, moving,
man. We really are privileged and, you know what I'm saying, very honored to have you. Here today and whatnot. You've been such a blessing and a light, and we've learned so much.
Thank you.
And you know, this is the first time, but I know it ain't gonna be the last time we have you on the show, man. Is there anything you like to say to the new Jack Thriller City audience before we get out of here?
So shout out to the Jack Thriller City audience. Shout out to Gigi, Erica. Shout out to Playboy. Listen, me and you gotta talk.
Okay.
Because me and you go way back.
Way back.
And you told me you married with kids. Now, can you say something about that real quick before I say what I need to say? Because I was really, really shocked and surprised.
Oh, yes.
Yeah, can you just real quick, if you can.
So, I am married.
Yeah.
My wife's name is Chelsea. She is a Gemini. Shout out to Gemini Gang. Her birthday is 6/9. Shout out to my son, Kai. He'll be 4 in November.
Mm-hmm.
And it's just a beautiful thing being able to be present and be involved, and you know, every day I have my son. I work from home, so he's with me. He reads on a fourth grade level. He's 3 years old right now, and it's just a beautiful joy to be a part of his life, and as well as my wife. So,
how long you been married?
I'll be married 2 years in November.
Oh, you got over the hump.
Yeah.
2 years in October.
Yeah. October 4th. And I want to give a big shout out to DJ Samore, because no matter where she see me, no matter where we at, she going to ask me for my record and she going to play my shit every single time.
She's so
and she
genuine.
Been doing that
Very
forever.
Genuine.
Yeah. 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 You know what, Jack? Before I go, I want to pop my shit real quick.
Please.
You know what I'm saying?
Pop it.
You know, I've been in the business for a minute, right?
Okay.
And no matter where I go, I don't care if it's your neck of the woods, my neck of the woods. I got to give love to the DJs. You know, yep. DJ Bluetooth in the corner, I see you too. No matter what club I go to in Atlanta, the DJs, they see me and they be like, Coco, where the new music? You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
That makes me feel really good because people don't get asked that. And Playboy, I know you can attest to that. Anytime you out with us, our music going to get played all up and down.
100%.
And it's really hard to, you know, be like that in Atlanta. But I appreciate you guys that will bring me to a platform. This is my first time doing a podcast.
For real?
Oh, what? Hey. Okay. I was wondering why you were. Okay. Now it makes sense.
You was dope.
Thank you.
I wonder why you were asking me them questions and stuff. Like, yeah, what are we going to talk about? What's going on?
I needed to know. I've done all kind of other things, but I've never done a podcast. So
this was cool, right?
Yeah, it was great.
Did we hurt you?
No. Y'all was talking about informative things, and then I learned a lot from Playboy, you know, and I learned a lot from Erica and Gigi, and then I told you, me, you got to talk because you the baby, you feel me? But I just appreciate being on platforms like this because it is, you know, hard to keep up. Yeah. It's hard to keep up with Atlanta. So if you keep your foot in the door, you're doing something.
I'm from old Atlanta. Yeah. The real Atlanta.
I love old Atlanta, okay?
Old Atlanta.
You know what I mean? But
I'm Atlanta.
Shout out to you guys. I'm going to just plug my next show, Ratchet Rehearsals.
Please.
April 22nd. That's my next show date. So make sure y'all pop out and perform.
We're going to be there.
Y'all gonna be there, Playboy? You performing?
Coming too.
Yeah, we
performing.
Gigi, you know Rain, right? Rain
April 22nd. Rehearsal.
Rain.
Yeah, but that I do my event there.
That's where it's at?
Yeah, I've been doing it there for 2 years, but I do it once a month. You know, it's low key. It's a private event, so it's not like a part of the club. They just start. I used to do it on Sundays, and I changed it to Mondays.
Oh, okay.
Oh yeah, Monday. Yeah,
but now I got you know.
I opened Rain. Bartending there, so it's crazy because that was when I first stopped drinking, and that was a real test of me too. If I can be behind a bar and be around so much alcohol,
you remember that when she came?
Being that motherfucker point, like this,
I hadn't even had a glass of wine or nothing. but I was good. It helped. It actually helped. Like yeah. I would be the. I mean, of course, you know. So I was smoking my weed, but being a sober person in a room full of drunk people is actually fun.
It is,
yeah. Mm. And then I'll tell y'all what else off camera because I don't want to spill my secret.
Okay.
Yeah. That's what you're right. That's
but
the old
let's just
fox.
Say, let's just say me not drinking. Let's just say me not drinking was making me money. Was making me more money.
Got you. Yeah. You're throwing back them water shots. Yeah, that's smart. But yeah, y'all can follow me on my Instagram. Everybody in this room, y'all gotta pull y'all phone out.
Yes,
I'm gonna look at everybody if y'all don't follow me.
Hey, Jazz, follow her. Hey, we about to get some behind the scenes, get some pictures.
BTS. Yeah. So my Instagram is Coco Kiss Me, and that's C O C O K I S S M E. And I'm gonna follow everybody back in here, so don't think I'm
that's what love do.
Yes, kiss me.
We will
follow me back too.
Come on now. Let's take some pictures, y'all.
Yeah.
Come
on,
let's go.
Thank you.
I love you.
I love you too. My little sister.
Y'all gotta get me out of the house. I'm in town. I do not come out of the house. This is like an event.